So here we'll discuss about extendable hashing. So extendable hashing is a dynamic hashing method where buckets and directories in buckets are used to hash the data. Okay, so here first we need to see the terms which we use in this extendable hashing. One is the directory, buckets, global depth, local depth, bucket splitting, directory, expansion. So coming to the directories, so let us draw how hash frame looks like initially. So this is the initial representation of a hash frame. So these are directories, these are buckets. Okay. So what is this directory? So directory is mainly it's used to store address of the buckets. So the address of this buckets, it is stored in this directory. Okay, and an ID is assigned to each directory. So here, if you observe, the ID which is assigned to this directory is 0, whereas here the ID assigned is 1. And then bucket, it is used to hash the data. So the set of keys which are given to us, they will be placed inside the bucket. For example, given elements are 1, 2, 3, 5, 7. Then I inserted 1, 2, 3 into the first bucket, and remaining 5 is inserted into the second bucket. Then 7, if I try to insert 7 into the first bucket, then it causes bucket overflow, because here we are assuming size of the bucket as 3. So it can store only 3 keys. Whereas if you try to insert the fourth key, it leads to bucket overflow. This concept is similar to stack overflow. Just like how overflow situation occurs when you try to insert elements into the stack, exceeding the stack size. In the same way, here also, if you try to insert element into the bucket other than crossing its limit, then it causes bucket overflow. So whenever bucket overflow occurs, and in that case you need to split the bucket into two parts, so that this last bucket, it still remains the same because we are not making any modifications to that. So this is your last bucket where we already inserted 5. So now if you split this bucket, then this bucket will be divided into two parts. So based on the binary representation of these numbers, or by taking LSB bits, number of LSB bits into consideration, we'll place these 4 elements into these two buckets. Assume that we inserted 1, 2 into the first bucket and 3, 7 into the second bucket. Now there is no concept of overflow here. So like that, we can resolve this bucket overflow situation. Then, what is this directory expansion? So whenever the bucket splitting occurs, then in that case you need to check whether local depth of overflowing bucket is equal to global depth. So what is this local depth and global depth? So global depth is nothing but the value which is associated with the directory. So here, initially global depth is equal to 1, because this is the initial frame. So I told you we are assuming one initial hash frame. So here value will be 1. Whereas for buckets also initial value will be 1. So before splitting. Okay. So when you try to split the bucket, then you need to check the local depth of the overflowing bucket. So this is the bucket that we want to split, right? So now you need to check the local depth and global depth. So before splitting, this is a case, right? So in that case, local depth is equal to global depth. So this is the overflowing bucket. So check this point again. This is performed when local depth of overflowing bucket is equal to global depth. So this is nothing but the overflowing bucket. And local depth of this overflowing bucket is equal to global depth of this directory. So in this case, when you split this bucket, then you need to expand this directory also. So that means when you split this bucket into two parts, by taking 1, 2 and 3, 7, and the last bucket is still the same. In this case, you need to expand this directory also. So expand this directory. So initially directory contains only two fields, whereas now it contains four fields. So here the binary value ID should be taken as a 2-bit binary number. So possibilities are 00011011. These are IDs of the directory, IDs which are assigned to every directory. Now this local depth, this global depth will be changed to 2 because we are taking 2-bit values now. Earlier it is 1. And also here, as we divided this bucket into two parts, now this local depth will be changed to 2 for both these buckets, because we divided one bucket into two parts. So every bucket, so in those two buckets you need to make this change. Local depth will be changed to 2, whereas the bucket on which no changes are implemented, that value still remains the same. So this is the bucket where we have not performed any changes. So that value is still 1, which has changed only local depth of the bucket which we divided into two parts. Okay, so let us try to insert these keys into the buckets now. So here local depth, global depth and local depth initially they are 1. So hash function, it returns 1 LSB of every key. Okay, so if you try to insert 8, it returns 1 LSB of 8, which is nothing but 0, right? So take 1 LSB of every number and try to insert them into the buckets. So first insert 8. So 8 is now mapped to the directory with ID equal to 0. Okay, so it is mapped to the directory with ID equal to 0. Next, for 12 also it is 0 only, so insert it in the same bucket. 14, last bit is 0, insert it in the same bucket. 30, last bit is 0. Okay, now if you try to insert 30, what happens? So here the bucket size is only 3, but if you try to insert 4th element, then bucket overflow occurs. So here you need to split this bucket into two parts. So split this bucket into two parts, and last bucket it still remains the same. So when you split this bucket, this local depth also changes. So it will be incremented by 1. So now it is 2, because this is split into two parts. So both of them contains local depth as 2. Last bucket is still 1 only, as we have not done any changes to that. Expand this directory. Now, what is the global depth for this directory? It is also incremented by 1. So it is 2. So you need to take 2-bit numbers here. So earlier, as global depth is 1, we considered 0 and 1, 1-bit number. Now you need to take 2-bit binary values. So values will be 0, 0, 0 1 1 0 1 1. So rehashing should be done here. So earlier by considering last one bit, we inserted keys into the buckets. Whereas here now you need to check last two bits of every number and then insert the values. So take 8, 12. So last two bits are 0 0 0 0. So you can insert them in the same bucket. So place it in another bucket. 14 and 13. Now 8 and 12, they are mapped to the bucket with ID equal to 00. Sorry, with mapped to the directory with ID equal to 00. Because they are having last two bits as 00. Now, so 10 points. 14 and 13 should point to the directory with ID equal to 101, not 01, right? So this is the representation. Okay. Now 18. 18 means 10. So insert in the same bucket. Next 11. 7 is 11. Last two bits. So place it in the last bucket. 15 contains 11. So place it in the last bucket as they are mapped to directory with ID equal to 11. Next, 17. So 17 ID is 01. Okay, so here 01 and 11, both of them. So here all three items, they are mapped to directories with ID 01 and 11. So you can insert them, insert 17 into the same bucket. Next, coming to 28. 28 is 00, so that means first bucket. So if you try to insert fourth element, what happens? Bucket overflow. So again you need to split this bucket into two parts. So split this. And your directory also expands. So now global depth is incremented by 1 and this bucket local depth is incremented by 1. So as we split it, this bucket, two buckets local depth will be 3, whereas this one remains the same and last one also it remains same. Now insert keys. So here we expanded this directory, right? So here it is 3 now. So you need to take 3 bit binary number now. So take 3 bit numbers 000 001 010 011 100 101 110 111. Okay. Now again rehashing should be done, right? So you need to take last three bits in this given keys. So let us take last three bits and insert the keys. So last three bits of 8 are 000. So 8 should be mapped to the directory with ID equal to 000. Next, are there any other numbers with ID 000? Yes, 16. So out of 8, 12, 16, 28, 8 and 16 are having last three bits as 000. Next, check 12. 12 is 100. So place 12 in other bucket. Check 28. 28 is also 100. when pH should be placed in this other bucket. So where is 100? Here. Okay, next, 14, 30 and 18. So take 14, 14 is 110. So you can place these elements as it is, as there is no overflow here. And now try to map them to the corresponding directories. So 14 means 110. So where is 110? Here it is. Next, for 13, 110, yes, 18, 010. So mark this 18 to the directory with ID equal to 010. So 010. Next, move to the last one. 7. 7 means 111. 15 is also 111. Take 17. 17 means 001. So 001. Okay. Next. So what are the leftover ones? We have 011 and 101. So map them to the last bucket. Okay, so now this is done. Now you need to insert element 10. So insert 10. Your last three digits are 010. So it should be placed in this bucket. Because 010 is because this bucket is mapped to directory 010. So insert 10. So this bucket is already full. So if you try to insert 10, then overflow occurs. So you need to split this bucket now. So see the difference now. Here you need to check the local depth and global depth also. So global depth is greater than local depth in this case. So global depth is 3, whereas local depth of this bucket, because in this bucket only we want to insert element. So you need to take local depth of this bucket, which is 2. So 3 is greater than 2. In this case, you should not expand directory. So if this is the case, you need to expand the directory. Only you need to split the bucket. That's enough. So when global depth is equal to local depth, then in that case only directory expansion takes place. If you observe this, here global depth and local depth, both of them are same. So when you split the bucket, here a directory should also be expanded. Similarly, in the previous case, local depth and global depth, both of them are same. So when you split the bucket, directory expansion should occur. Whereas here scenario is different. Global depth is greater than local depth. So no need to expand the directory, just split this bucket. So now split this into two buckets. Final representation is this. So earlier we have only 4 buckets, whereas now we'll have 5. And this directory still remains the same. So insert these keys 8, 16, 12, 28, so 18, 10, 14, 30, 7, 15 and 17. So map this keys to the corresponding directories. So mapping is almost same. 001 to last bucket. 010. So 010, It points to this one. Next, 0, 1, 1. Last bucket. 1, double 0. Second one. 1, 0, 1. Last bucket. 1, 1, 0. This bucket and triple 1 is points to the last bucket. So this is the final representation after inserting all keys into the buckets.